Are you looking for a modern appointment booking system that's easy to set up and it looks good? Well, Trafft might be the solution for you. So I'm going to show you how it actually looks and how to set it up on this video. So let's go jump over to my dashboard right now. All right, this is my Táve dashboard, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to get around. So for example, we're going to view our new customers, and we can use a filter to view by week, month, last 3 months, and last 6 months. We're also able to view our revenue, and again, we have the filters, the occupancy, the appointments booked, the daily occupancy based on colors. So we have a quick glance. We have the last booked appointments, the performance by employees, so we know how our employees are performing when they book with them. The services, how we're able to, what's booked more often than the other ones, and you're able to analyze that. Now, how is the booking system going to look and how are we going to view it? Well, by default, when you create an account on Táve, we're going to have a special link, which is ourbrand.taft.com, right? But we're also able to connect our custom domain. So that means that instead of using Táve as a domain, we have our own. So for example, you can create like I did. So I created a domain, let me show you, which is booking@bmmedia.com. So instead of using their domain, I have my branded domain. Now, some of these settings you will have and some of them you won't, depending on the plan that you choose. The other way that we can look at this, well, let's go to the site first, okay? I open my custom domain and we're able to look at this modern looking booking system. We can customize a couple of things in this. We're able to book from here. So for example, if I want to book a 1 hour group meeting, which is $20, it loads the image. We have the description for it, the duration, the occupancy, the extras available if you want to add extra time, hosted by, which is me. And we have the option to pay on PayPal or on site because I have enabled that. We also have available to set up Stripe and Razorpay. I'll show you in a bit. We can select the extra minutes that we want. Book now if we're good to go like that. I can continue as an account or I can continue as guest. I really like this because sometimes we don't want to go through the hassle of signing up. We just want to continue as guest and we have that option. So again, it's letting us know what we've selected. We can continue. And is it going to be who's coming? Just me or choose a number of people? In this case, just me. I'll continue. I'll select the date from the dates that I have available. So for example, you can view that I don't have Saturday and Sunday, so they can't select it. And I can set what I want to have available and not. So for example, I'll select the 3rd. And here's a date on the top. We can select the time. So for example, at 12. And we can go ahead and continue. Fill out the information and pay with PayPal and we're good to go. We're also able to add coupons to give some discounts. Now that is the direct link to it. That's hosted by them. I don't have to do anything and it's just super easy to set up. Now, if I wanted to embed it on my site, that's also available. You can have a PHP site or a WordPress site and just install by embedding it or even Shopify, Wix. And if you have the option to add the HTML code, well, this is my site from WordPress and it's available here. Check that out. Oh, that's also my setup. Let's go forward. There we go. Here's the site. I selected, continue, and this is embedded on my site. So if you don't have a plan where you have a custom domain, well, this is a good option. You just embed it on the site and it's going to have your own domain because you're embedding it inside of your site. So that is the view for it. Now, how do we set this up? This is one of the most important things about a booking appointment system is setup. Why? Because we're going to know how powerful it actually is and if it has the settings that we need. So for example, I would recommend to get started with the settings, which is the little gear icon there. We have the general settings, which is, for example, default time slot. If you know that your default time slot is always 30 minutes and some other ones might change, but you're always setting up 30 minutes, well, it's good to set it up at the beginning so you save time. So if it's 1 hour or more, you have that as a default. Use the service duration as a booking time slot. You can enable that. The default appointment status is approved or pending. So if someone books at a certain time and it's just they're going to book on it, it's going to be automatically approved. But if it's pending, we have to approve it, which is a good idea and not. It's just going to depend on how you want to set it up. The minimum time required before booking. So for example, they can't book before this amount of days, weeks, hours, or whatever. What is this used for? So let's just say I want to book right now. The minimum time frame required is gonna be set up by this. So for example, if I set up 3 hours, I can't book something for 1 hour. I have to wait. Unless I want to book something before three, that'll be available. Or let's just say you don't want anyone to book with 1 day in advance. So it has to be after 24 hours from the time of booking. This gives us time to prepare and know that it's booked, all right? And the minimum time required before canceling, again, time frame, we have that available. So they can't cancel, I don't know, 30 minutes before the actual booking. Hey, you know what? I'm already set up, I'm ready to go, I'm just waiting for you to come in. So you wanna have this available, so I don't know, it just depends what you wanna do. You don't wanna give them, I don't know, 12 hours, and that way you have time to say, hey, you know what? Okay, good thing I wasn't there and I wasn't ready to start the meeting, okay? Minimum time required before scheduling, rescheduling. Again, we have the time frame, the number of days available for booking in advance. So maybe, I don't know, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, however you want to set it up. You can't book after that, okay? And the global settings. So depending on the country, you will have the settings. In this case, I'm in Mexico, so it's day, month, year. But in United States, it's the other way around. It's month, day, and year. And it's just gonna depend how you want to set that up. The time format, this is how you can see it. For example, this is a 12-hour format, hour, minutes, and AM or PM if you want to set that up. And the time zone, first day of the week, default for phone country code, and go ahead and save it. Really important that you set that up. I mean, time zone is crucial in this type of system, all right? Next options that we have is the business. So in this case, it's called Bimbi Media, which is my business. Address, website, phone, and company bank account if they want to do a bank transfer. The office hours, again, super important to set this up. In this case, we can add more time frames because maybe we want to have a break, or you know you eat lunch at 2 to 3 p.m. so you don't want anyone to book at that time frame. So what I would do is, for example, if it's gonna be 2 p.m., I'll add another one, and then I'll start off at, there you go, 4. And we'll end that, I don't know, 8 p.m. There we go. We added the time frame and we have a break. So they can't book in that time frame. And again, we set these days on or off. So in this case, Saturday and Sunday is off. If I want to turn it on, just go ahead and do that and go ahead and save it. SMS notifications, if you have that available, well, you set that up. They take credits. Email notifications, we can set this up. What type of notifications do we want to use? And do we want to enable them or disable them and customize it if we like. So these are variables that are grabbed from the actual persons that filled it out. So the service name is gonna grab from the service name, the customer full name is gonna grab from the variable of their name, so it looks customized. And we can set these up for customers and to employee, okay? The payments, the currency that you're going to use, the price symbol, the price separator, and the number of decimals. Features and integrations, really important part here to set up. So if you want to have coupons available or you don't, you disable them, configure coupons to add them to give them the discount. The custom domain, I already set it up. It's fairly easy if you just know how to add the DNS on whatever you want to use, cPanel, Cloudflare, or Namecheap, whatever you're using for the hosting provider DNS, you just set it up, the A service. Custom fields, do we want to have them available or not? Maybe it's something that it's not required for your business, so you just disable it or keep it on. The extras, the group booking, multiple locations, online payments, SMTP email, so it's sent from your email's domain and not from Táve, and special days, all right? We also have the integrations available, so two tabs inside of here. We can add our Facebook Pixel, Google Analytics, Google Task, Tag Manager. I've already set up my Google Calendar, so the booking, when it's done, obviously it's added to my Google Calendar. That way I know that a booking is coming nearby. And Google Meet, MailChimp, Outlook Calendar, SendFox, Zapier, and Zoom. Super important that they have Zapier because you can do a whole lot with that information if you have Zapier. I'm gonna go into the Google Calendar just to show you the options that we have available. So once you are connected, like I am already, we have options available. So in this case, I've enabled Google Meet, but if I'm not going to use Google Meet, I could disable it, and I have other options available. So in this case, I'll remove Google Calendar, busy slots, and I have that enabled also. A lot of options here. user roles, and if you can add a user here, their name, last name, email, and what they have to do, right? Required user to choose new password at login or not. The customization for the website. This is my embed code. That is what I use to embed on my WordPress site. I just grab this code and we're good to go. All the information is updated when I update here. The booking form settings, if I want to keep these or change them, how they're going to work by steps, you can do that. Redirect URL after successful booking. So let's just say that someone books and at the end you want to send them to a, I don't know, a special promotion or to the homepage or whatever you want to do with it. Set email field as mandatory. You don't want them to skip it. Again, set phone number as mandatory. If you want to have that phone number because you want to have a way to contact them in case you have to cancel or let them know or confirm, just depends what you want to use it for. Show time zone option to customers. Really good option, especially if you have people booking appointments from all over the world. The language and labels, you have English and German available. We have the labels here. Customization, the page title, the selected primary color, in this case it's blue. I can use a custom color there. Select fonts, these are the fonts that are available. We can preview it. Show made with Trafft mark, Trafft. If you want to change it, well, if you want to remove it, well, you just select it. The website logo, the fav icon from the little tabs on the browser. Account setting, and if you want to add custom code for CSS or JS, you have that available in case you want to add, for example, a chat widget or just something that you might want to use inside of that page inside of here. So it's already set and embedded. Once you set that up, my next recommendation is to jump to employees. Add the employee because this is where we're going to tie them to the plans and all of that. So for example, add employee. Obviously we have the required data, which is a simple data there. Assigned service. So for example, a certain employee might be assigned to some services and some not. In case you have, for example, you're offering service for SEO, marketing, social media management, or whatever, and not every employee is, I don't know, has a capacity for those jobs. Well, for example, one hour group meeting. So only that would be enabled for this particular person, okay? And maybe this one charges more or less than what the other one charges. You set that up there. The working hours for this employee. So this employee might work, I don't know, 7 days a week, or he might work only Mondays or whatever, okay? You enable and disable and add the time frames here. The days off for this employee, we can add days off. So for example, I don't know, Christmas, Thanksgiving, New Year, Chinese New Year, or whatever you want to disable, you add that there. The special days. So for example, again, we can add special days added here, which employee has no upcoming special days. So a special day, he would charge different. I think that's how that would work. I'd have to confirm that and I'll tell you in the description. Next thing I would do is set up the services. Okay, so and this is where the services are. For example, the three services that you saw on the booking demo that I just showed you are from right here. We can add more services. We have unlimited on this plan, but again, it will depend on the plan that you're on. So the service, we have the name, the category, the price. Whoops, I clicked on the image. The image for that, the tax, duration, all the information, the locations. If you have locations added, we can add those here on the left. The buffer time before, the buffer time after, just all that information. The extras for that one. Remember we saw, for example, if they want to book 30 minutes extra and it charges so much, well, they have the extra options. You can add extra things, whatever you want to add there. And the gallery for this service. Next thing I would set up is locations, if you have locations enabled and if you want to use that. If not, disable it. The finance, this is the finance information. We could view our invoices, our settings for the invoices, invoice customization. This is what's going on right now for the invoice. They will be adding more templates for this and additional notes. Transactions, we're able to view them here. The taxes, we can add our taxes rates right there. Depending on the country that you are from, you would set your own tax. The coupons, if we wanna create coupons or not. Again, if you're not going to use coupons, you can disable that, okay? Next thing we have is the appointments view right here. So we're able to view the appointments listed right there. We can approve, pending, cancel, or reject it, and we can also edit them. So edit the appointment manually in case someone sent you an email, and you know what, can we rebook? We can do it that way. We can export data, we can share appointments, and we can create a new appointment manually if we did the appointment somewhere else, or we did it, I don't know, via phone or something like that, you add it there manually. And we're also able to view our calendar's view depending on what we have going on. So for example, Monday we have that customer example again for 2 hours meetings, and we're able to view them here. And we're also able to add new appointments there. But there you go. And basically that is Trafft. You have a lot of options available, easy to set up. Basically everything has its own information of what it's going to do when you enable it or disable it. Super easy to set up custom domain, embedded, or just use their own link. It's super easy to set up. They have really good documentations for all the things you need. Whatever I looked for, it was available there without having any problems. And if I need support, well, I ask them there. But there you go. That is Trafft. It looks modern. It's good looking. It's hosted by them, so I don't have to take that doing it my own hosting or setup or anything. But if you want to just embed it on your site also, that's possible. Well, there you go. If you guys want to check out a link that's going on, that link will be in the description. And that link will help me out because it's an affiliate link. So it gives you a small commission and it won't cost you a single cent more than what it already costs. I thank you all for watching. My name's George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.